Hello, butterflies. Hello, hello. Welcome to Monique's Tarot. This is your Earth Signs May 2022 reading. Come in Taurus, come in Virgo, come in Capricorn. Hello, Earth Signs. How are things? I hope you're doing well. I hope you're taking some time to really connect with yourself as we get closer to the solar eclipse and clear out all of the things that you want to leave behind in April and welcome in all those new things that you'd like to accept in May. Hello, hello, Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorn. Okay, so these happen once a month. So what I'll do is I'll have the link for the timestamp within the description below so you can find your sign or you can stay and support all of the other earth signs. So welcome in. We're gonna start here first with Taurus. So hello, Taurus butterflies. Hello, hello. My mom is actually a Taurus, so I have a very direct and intimate relationship with Taurus, with my mom being a Taurus. And I'm also a Virgo moon for those earth signs wondering. Okay, butterflies, welcome, welcome. Calling in energies for Taurus butterflies, May 2022. 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 Okay, Taurus butterflies, let's pull in your wild offering oracles as well, and then we'll also pull in some base tarot here. Pulling in wild offering oracles for Taurus, May 2022. Pulling in wild offering oracles for Taurus, May 2022. Pulling in wild offering oracles for Taurus, May 2022. Pulling in wild offering oracles, earth sign energy for Taurus, Hierophant card energy for May 2022. All right, Taurus butterflies, and let's pull in one more love oracle. Calling in love oracle energies for Taurus, May 2022. Calling in love oracle energies for Taurus, May 2022. Calling in love oracle energies for Taurus, May 2022. Okay, Taurus butterflies, your butterfly affirmation reads, I give myself permission to switch off my mind and have some fun. I was definitely, as I was moving through your shuffle for your starting oracles here, I definitely felt very active brain energy. Now, I am an air sign myself, and also when I'm channeling, that normally happens, but it was just a different energy. It's almost like it's being felt throughout the entire body. So for some of you Taurus butterflies, you're struggling with actually being able to quiet the mind and allowing yourself the permission to say, I deserve this. Some of you I'm sensing just feel like you need to prove something, or you need permission, or you need to be able to validate yourself to others of why you're actually doing what you're doing. But there's a really strong call from this card for you to give yourself permission first and then switch off your mind so that you can have a little bit more internal peace here in May. Your wild offering oracle here reads patience. The card reads, if you've tried forever to shift a problem, there's probably something to learn from embracing it. May I let this be for now. Help me relax and trust every need will be met. often change soon follows. So Taurus butterflies, if you're feeling impatient, and I'm definitely getting the sense with this active activity, it's almost like some of you are seeking results right now. You're working to actually put things into fruition. And the thing with the, now that I'm thinking about it, actually with this solar eclipse moon, it's in Taurus, the new moon right now, the solar eclipse that's coming up April 30th. I do have a video out there on that. It's in Taurus, so it's within your sign. So yes, you all are definitely feeling like you want to get out there. Taurus, of course, is all about material matters, kind of family matters, financial matters, really having good grounding, and also making sure that you feel really secure. So with this moon and eclipse really illuminating all of that, there's an even bigger call for you, Taurus, to feel really grounded and secure in what you're doing. So I could see how, particularly for Taurus, you would feel a little bit impatient because you are managing not only the energies of yourself, but you're feeling everyone else get into this energy. So you don't really have that standout energy where normally you are that stabilizer. You may be having some energy to really get those finances and things reflected back, which feels a little bit more uncommon to you going into May. And then your love oracle, Taurus, for May reads, old feelings are resurfacing, and again you find yourself on an emotional roller coaster. Don't fight it. Instead, allow these feelings to surface without judging them. They are neither good nor bad. They are simply a part of you. Own them, embrace them, and love them. Bless the past and be grateful for the deep and profound healing that is taking place. I'm getting this two-sided message from the guides with this card. For some of you that are within shared soul space, there's some old feelings that are resurfacing where you're just seeing either your partner in a new light. For those of you in family, you're starting to have some old feelings that are resurfacing, maybe some old discussions. For some of you, this could be around health or finance with the Taurus solar eclipse, but also this could just be an emotional connection, how you actually are connecting with people, how you're actually having views of neither good nor bad, but you're really grateful for what has happened. For those of you that are single, you may be thinking about a particular person. You may be thinking about those past things and how they went and wanting things to be better. I mean, that's really common. Everyone has memories about folks from the past, but particularly for you with this love oracle, Taurus, it's almost like you are being called in May to just embrace these emotions as they come to you and just be really thankful for the lessons that you learned from it. Okay, Taurus butterflies, we're just gonna put these to the side for the moment. We'll come back to these. And let's call in your base tarot here. Calling in tarot energies for Taurus, May 2022 from the Archangels. Calling in energies for Taurus from the Archangels, May 2022. Calling in energies for Taurus from the Archangels, May 2022. Calling in energies from the Archangels for Taurus, May 2022. Earth energies, rooted energies. Emotional release energies. Calling in energies for Taurus for May 2022. Okay, Taurus butterflies, center your energy as we pull your base tarot. Within your elevation of spirit, we have the Dreamer for May 2022. Within your healing, we have the Sun, Taurus. Within your work and business endeavors, we have the Queen of Wands. We have the Nine of Cups within your personal life, and we have strength within your unexpected surprises. Calling in clarifying energies for Taurus, May 2022. Calling in clarifying energies for Taurus, May 2022. Calling in clarifying energies. Calling in support from the ancestors for Taurus butterflies, May 2022. Calling in feminine, clarifying, ancestral energies for Taurus, May 2022. Clarifying the dreamer Taurus butterflies, we have the Eight of Cups. Clarifying the Sun within your healing, we have the Two of Pentacles. Clarifying the Queen of Wands within your work and business endeavors, we have the Nine of Cups. Clarifying the Magician. Clarifying the Nine of Cups, we have the Seven of Wands. And clarifying strength within your unexpected surprises, we have the Ten of Pentacles. Okay. Taurus butterflies, for May, within your healing, I see that many of you have an opportunity for a really fresh start with the Dreamer Archangel card here. You're really pushing your fears aside and you're taking that leap of faith. I can see from your butterfly affirmation here that many of you are working hard and you're having some trouble with switching off your mind, but I think that's because you're walking away from a really tough time. And I'm just sensing that many of you have been needing this fresh start. The old feelings that you have, I think it's just a part of your healing process and where you are right now, whether that be with a person, we'll find out as we move through this draw, or perhaps some things that you've been wanting to be more settled. But I'm sensing just from the Cups card that it, for many of you, it's around relations with the emotions of the Cups. For your healing, we have the Sun. So this is amazing. You always, the Sun is the brightest card within tarot. So it's a time of really good joy and celebration. I can see here in this path of healing for you as you're walking away from those things that don't serve you emotionally, you are really having some good epiphanies. You needed to make some choices within your material realm, which is so fitting of the solar eclipse. Definitely continue to do that. There's a lot of gratitude and plans are working out well for you, Taurus. So I'm just sensing that many of you are very structured in how you're doing things. You have a good plan. You have a good eye with how you'd like to move forward. So definitely continue to do that, Taurus butterflies. Within your work and business endeavors, we have the Queen of Wands. So many of you are brilliant and talented. You just have so many good ideas, and many folks are benefiting from the care that you're giving them and acknowledging their ideas, as well as being able to have your ideas elevated. Now, with the Queen, that's fire energy. So Aries, Leo, and Sagittarius energy. So a lot of you are demonstrating a lot of strength. You're setting in good structure with that good Emperor energy that comes from Aries. And also Sagittarius is about making sure that you have balance. So I see that many of you with this Wands energy, you're doing very well. The Queen really encompasses all of those and she brings it into fruition. And you really have a strong belief in yourself. When you pair the Queen of Wands with the Magician, it's like you can create whatever you want. You have the ideas. You are really sharp here in May and bringing those ideas to fruition, and you're alchemizing it. So not only are you just having these ideas with the experience of the Queen, but you're really pushing things forward. So this is really beautiful for you within your work life, Taurus, in May. For your personal life, we have the Nine of Cups, supported by the Seven of Wands. So Nine of Cups is like wish fulfillment. You just have really good balance within your emotional life. I'm just seeing across this board here, like, Taurus, you're gonna have a really incredible, very spiritually supported month in May. Between the Dreamer, the Sun, the Queen of Wands, the Nine of Cups and strength, you've made so many good decisions and you're alchemizing things. I mean, even the Ten of Pentacles here. I do see within your personal life that many of you, as you're elevating in this really magical time and good fortune with the Nine of Cups, being emotionally fulfilled, your faith is going to be elevated in May, Taurus. And also, there is a little bit of conflict here with the Seven of Wands where you may feel a bit defensive. But I'm getting from here, this is where you're trying to give yourself the permission to really switch off your mind. And some of these old feelings may have to do with some of these other wands where others are kind of more critical of what you're doing. But the guides are showing that with this strength here for you and your unexpected surprises, you're stepping into your personal power. So continue to do that. And there's a compassion to strength with forgiveness. So you could be forgiving others. For those of you, I'm just feeling called to say that are within shared soul space or coupled, if you're having some tough arguments in May, I see that you're going to get through it because the strength here is really pulling in that forgiveness and you're getting your family life back on track. Not that it was off track, I'm not seeing that here, but just with this Eight of Cups emotion that was in your elevation of spirit where it's not even like you're walking away from something, but you're walking away metaphorically where it's like you're not sitting within the same emotion. I'm just getting the sense that many of you Taurus have been sitting within a certain emotion and you've been waiting on either family members, community, or within a relationship. You've been like, okay, I want to help people out, or I want to be there for someone or people or community, but I need to take care of myself. And I'm just getting this, you're taking care of yourself energy and you're really allowing yourself to dream. And then here with this Ten of Pentacles and strength, again, it's getting things back on track. And when you have the Nine of Cups supported by the Ten of Pentacles, it's showing that you're really taking care of your emotions first. This is the highest level of individual emotion you can have before the Ten of Cups, which brings you into that family life. So I can just see here, you're really grounding yourself. You might have some resistance, but it's needed for the benefit of your family, the goals, and really having your structure and stability, which will be illuminated even more by the Taurus new moon solar eclipse on April 30th. All right, Taurus butterflies. So remember to give yourself permission to switch off your mind and have some fun. You have so much to look forward to here in May. So really enjoy that. Have patience. If you've tried forever again, the guides are saying here to shift a problem, there's something to learn. But for now, let this be. And really that message is coming loud and clear throughout what you're doing. You've made some choices with the Two of Pentacles to stabilize some things within your life, within the material realm. And it's proving that you made the right decision here because it's really blossoming here in May. And then also with your love oracle, Taurus butterflies, if there are things that pop up for you emotionally, just let those old feelings resurface, but don't fight it. Allow these feelings to appear without judging them and just embrace and love them. All right, Taurus butterflies, we're gonna shift over to Virgo. Hello, Virgo butterflies. Hello, hello. Just give me a second here to clear out the energies of the previous draw. For those of you that are listening to the entire Earth Signs May 2022 reading, thank you so much for supporting the other Earth Signs. As always, if these words are resonating with you, feel free to like, subscribe, and share with your community. And also your donations are always appreciated as the channel grows and we continue to connect on these transformational journeys together. Okay, Virgo butterflies, rational action thinkers. Virgos occasionally take on too much, but Virgo is represented by the Hermit. Virgos love to have some alone time to really gather, recharge, and start to organize and work hard and get out there. All right, Virgo butterflies. Calling in energies for Virgo, May 2022. Calling in energies for Virgo, Hermit energy, May 2022. Calling in energies, rational actions, possibly taking on too much. Hermit energy for Virgo, May 2022. Calling in energy from the spirit guides in Virgo, May 2022. Earth signs energy in Virgo, May 2022. Calling in wild offering energies for Virgo, May 2022. Calling in wild offering energies for Virgo, May 2022. Pollen and wild offering energies for Virgo, May 2022. There's a very calm energy to your draw, Virgo. It's almost like you all are very comfortable in just the silence coming into May. Just a very peaceful feeling, kind of shuffling your cards, an ease to it. So we'll see how that rounds out here as we go through your oracles and also your tarot. Calling in Virgo energy for the love oracles, May 2022. Calling in love oracle energy for Virgo, May 2022. Calling in love oracle energy for Virgo, May 2022. Okay, Virgo butterflies, your butterfly affirmation reads, I don't need to control my life. I trust in magic and miracles. Wow. I mean, when you think about Virgo, there is an air of a bit of control with Virgo because Virgos are just so organized. So this is really telling me, Virgo butterflies, that you are in a time of believing right now. You are seeking some miracles. You're seeking some magic. You're allowing things to happen around you. For some of you, you may already be experiencing some of these magical things that are happening within your life. And the guides are really showing here that you don't need to control that. Allow things to happen in their time. Your wild offering oracle reads, Virgo, self-sufficiency. The ultimate self-sufficiency is relying on God. I don't mean hiding in a cave and saying, I don't need people. Instead, it's saying, God is my source, and I am willing to receive all the help, love, and support that wants to come. These cards here, between the butterfly affirmation and also self-sufficiency, it's showing here that many of you are definitely in a time of relying on yourself. But the guides are asking you to really rely on the spiritual guides, rely on God, call out to source, be willing to receive the help. And when you receive help, you are releasing control. You're trusting in the community and the people around you. You're trusting that you have all of your needs met. So definitely continue to be self-sufficient here, but also know that your self-sufficiency is not coming from you alone. It's coming from your higher source. It's coming from God. It's coming from your spiritual guides and ancestors. And then your love oracle for May 2022, Virgo reads, within the transcendental realm of your soul, there are endless universes, each inconceivably vast and at the same time inconceivably small. Even the tiniest particle of subatomic matter, there is endless expansion. Creation is a cosmic motion picture in which you are both director and actor. Look within and express outwardly the endless waves of love within you. May your love embrace the earth and fill all creation. So I'm sensing here, Virgo butterflies, that you're in a moment where you are connecting with someone where you could be creating things together. It's like both the director and actor for those of you that are possibly leading toward a relationship. And also for those of you that are single, you're really looking within, you're finding love within yourself, and you're starting to see endless possibilities. So I think that's really bringing in this magical nature to you. Okay, I had to move my cat there, Virgo butterflies. So with this, I'm just seeing that there's a really good expansion point You're creating a lot of good opportunity for yourself. There's a lot of good waves of love that are coming your way, Virgos. And speaking of my cat, just a lot of cleaning that she was doing when your reading started. So some of you may feel like you're cleaning. Maybe you're letting go of control by cleaning out those things that really don't serve you during this time. But there's just something about expansion. It's like you're preparing for some of, I'm just getting the sense from the self-sufficiency card that some of you have been somewhat codependent on others, or you have felt somewhat codependent as a way of control. And this is a very specific message. This is not all Virgos, but I'm just getting for some of you that you've been codependent on others because it feels safe. It feels secure. It feels like that's how you know your needs will be met. But the guides are asking you to be more self-sufficient and to trust your source as a way to narrow down and also understand the best direction forward. Okay, Virgo butterflies, we're gonna get some clarification here around your reading. There's a lot of mixed energies, so just bear with me, Virgo butterflies. Calling in energies for Virgo, May 2022. Calling in energy for Virgo from the Archangels, May 2022. Calling in energy for Virgo, May 2022. Calling in energy for Virgo, May 2022. Calling in Hermit energy for Virgo, May 2022. Within your elevation of spirit, we have the Five of Cups. Within your healing, we have the Seven of Cups. Within your work and business endeavors, we have the Nine of Swords. We have the King of Swords within your personal life and the Emperor within your unexpected surprises for May. Calling in clarifying energies for Virgo, May 2022. 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 As I'm pulling your draw here, Virgo, it feels like some of you are waiting. It's like you're waiting for something to happen. Okay, let's talk through this, Virgo. So within your elevation of spirit, I'm seeing the Five of Cups. So there's a high focus on the negative right now. I'm definitely feeling within your reading like the mixed emotions and mixed thoughts. So forgive me if I come off a little bit scattered, but your energy is just really clear, Virgos. It's like I can just really feel it. So there's a forgiveness that you might have for others or that you may need to have for yourself here in May. The guides are really asking you to remember that everything happens for a reason. I can see here within your healing, there's like a double confirmation. So there were some choices or confusion that you had within the past that you're working to heal from. And that confusion is still with you and how you're working to heal, but now it's transforming into you need to make a choice. Some of you are really overanalyzing, Virgos, and need some clarity on what you desire to actually move forward. It's almost like there's too many options. Some of you are also thinking about what you invested in. I'm getting a sense from this Five of Cups, like you feel like you really invested in something emotionally. This has taken a toll on your health a bit. And then when we look into your work and business endeavors, Virgo, I'm definitely seeing the Nine of Swords. There's a lot of up in your head energy. Now, if we look at these connections and just slow this down a bit, with the Seven of Cups and Seven of Pentacles, this is telling me that there are a lot of unknowns. Sevens are all about mystery. They're all about introspection, a lot of analyzing. And also, Seven of Pentacles is telling me that the investments that you may make in May, you need to reevaluate them. I'm just getting a sense that some of you kind of jumped out there, whether it be financially or within your health realm. But there's a topsy-turvy energy here in May, and it may be because you need to refocus your energy. If we just pull in this, I don't need to control life, I trust in magic and miracles card for you, Virgo. I think some of these choices and how they haven't played out, it's making you feel a little off. So when we look into your personal life or your work life here, that's not a flub. That's probably intentional from the guides. Your work life is affecting your personal life, where you're really worrying. It's almost like some of you are waiting for something to happen work-wise. You're waiting for things to really turn around. This Justice card is telling me that there are some things that are in balance for some of you Virgos, where either a contract that you've been working to establish or a deal that you're trying to have come through, you're just up late at night thinking about it. But the thing I always like to encourage, butterflies, when we see cards that are really difficult, make sure that you use these points as a way to move forward, as a way to elevate yourself. So unfounded fear, the Nine of Swords, the positive of it is it's an opportunity to refocus your thoughts. What you think will become your reality. So know that the guides are working for you with justice. There will be an outcome here that turns in your favor, but you need to work on your thoughts first, is what the guides are asking. Now, within your personal life, I'm seeing that some of you are making a choice here for the benefit of your health and also the benefit of your finances when it comes to either love or family or future relationships. There's this King of Energy or King of Swords energy around you. Someone that's really objective in how they think, someone that's fair-minded. This person might even be like a public speaker or someone that can be a little bit unemotional within relationships. And you're trying to understand where they're coming from. I'm also getting a sense here that this could be you, Virgo butterflies, where you right now, because you're so in your emotions, you're trying to make choices, that you're coming off as this King of Swords. And the energy around you is you really need to stabilize some things within your finances. I'm just getting this message here that some of the investments that some of you have made, it's been a little funny. And so it's throwing you off right now and it's got you up late at night. So just reevaluate things. We are in this Taurus season with the solar eclipse coming up on April 30th. So this is a good time to really stabilize and understand what's happening around you. Now, for unexpected surprises, speaking of stability, you do have the Emperor. So the logic that you have right now, the organization that you're putting into things, it will change a situation around. It's like the guides are really asking you to take charge. And I think that's where the self-sufficiency card is coming in. For some of you, I'm just getting this message that you were so reliant on other folks that it just kind of left you out in the cold, where you really believe that they would take care of it and really you needed to take care of it. And so gaining some structure and discipline will really help turn this world around, because right now the world is upside down. So there's a thing about timing and making sure that you're actually providing more structure within your life. So with that, Virgo butterflies, I'm sending so much good energy out to you in May. You do have the ability to really move through the situation, move through these aspects within your life, and get things on track in May. That's the encouraging message that I'm getting from the guides, to just mind the structure that you have in May. And remember, you don't need to control life. Trust in magic and miracles. The guides are just waiting for you to call out. You have justice on your side. They are asking you to be more self-sufficient, but also rely on your spiritual guides and God. And also within your love this month, your love oracle is really reminding you that even the tiniest particles of subatomic matter, there's endless expansion. Creation is a cosmic motion picture in which you are both director and actor. So really look within and express outward the endless waves of love within you. Resetting yourself, that will really put you in the best foot forward here in May, Virgo butterflies. All right, with that, we're gonna shift over to Capricorn. Hello, Capricorn butterflies. Hello, hello. Give me just a second here to clear out these cards so that we can welcome in your energy. For those of you that are listening to the entire Earth Signs May 2022 reading, thank you so much for supporting the other Earth Signs. Thank you so much for your likes, subscribes, and donations as we connect together on your transformational journey. Thank you, thank you. Okay, Capricorns. Capricorn energy represented by the Devil card in tarot, the change makers. Sometimes possessive, a little bit controlling sometimes, but really smart in business, and Capricorns know exactly when to pull back. All right, Capricorn butterflies. Let me just do another wave of Palo Santo here. I'm clearing out the energy. And I just ask that you center yourself, releasing all those things from April that you'd like to release that no longer serve you, and opening yourself up to the possibilities of what you'd like to accept and bring into your life and soul experience in May. Calling in Capricorn energy for May 2022. 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 I actually feel called to just pull this top card for you. All right. Let's pull in a few more oracles before we get into your base tarot. Calling in wild offering energy for Capricorn, May 2022. Calling in wild offering energy for Capricorn, May 2022. Calling in wild offering energy for Capricorn, May 2022. Calling in wild offering energy for Capricorn, May 2022. I'm already receiving some messages from the guides with what you may be experiencing, but I also feel led to just hold before I speak too soon. Calling in love oracle energy for Capricorn, May 2022. Calling in love oracle energy for Capricorn, May 2022. Okay, Capricorn butterflies, let's get into your butterfly affirmation here. Your butterfly affirmation for May 2022 reads, "Even when things aren't perfect or don't seem to be working out, I choose to trust in life." This card is so simple in its phrasing, but also in pulling your cards, I definitely sense that some of you were feeling some sense of betrayal in some ways, just like a sense of like some past memories of possible betrayal that some of you may have experienced. And so the guides are really asking you, even though things don't seem perfect, things will work out in your favor. So definitely choose to trust in life. Your wild offering oracle here is related to creative blocks. The guides here say, if you are an artist of any kind, you can offer all work to the divine, making it God's alone. I offer this for the highest good to benefit the planet. Release me from any blocks and restrictions. May this serve all who need. From this, Capricorns, many of you are maybe getting into a little bit of the complacency is not the word, but you're just feeling like you're blocked creatively, or you feel like the ideas are not flowing as they normally would. And just getting like, this is not your norm, and it's definitely not the norm for Capricorn, because Capricorns are all about producing results. You all are really good within business, creation, and work. Like, that's a Capricorn. So this is unusual for you, and I can see that maybe that's throwing some of you off, where things aren't perfect. It's not at that same frequency or level where you would produce those results. But there is a benefit here of just calling out to the guides and asking them to release you from anything that you're not certain about, so that you can get that creative flow into your spirit and into the work that you're doing. Now, with your love oracle, the message here reads, you may not be aware of it yet, but a tapestry full of positive outcomes and spiritual blessings now permeates your aura. The gray clouds have lifted, replaced by soft, radiant light. The past will soon be behind you. Let go and embrace the positive times ahead. This to me reads like an on the verge card, where you're going through something emotionally. For some of you, you may not feel as connected to someone, or you may not feel as connected to your family. Again, I'm just sensing like there's a little bit of a shift in personality for many of you Capricorns recently. But those gray clouds that you're experiencing will soon be replaced by soft, radiant light. And as I was pulling your draw, there's definitely a softness to your reading, Capricorns, where just providing that ease and that moment to just reach out to the guides and ask them to allow you to move through this session, to move through this moment within your life, that's going to give you the confidence to really embrace the positive that's coming your way. It's actually going to prepare your soul to open up for it. Because first, before you can receive the positive, you have to start living the positive within. Okay, Capricorn butterflies, we're going to come back to these. And let's pull in your base tarot here for May 2022. Calling in Capricorn energies for May 2022 from the Archangels. Calling in Capricorn energies. Earth energies for Capricorn, May 2022. Calling in grounded energies for Capricorn, May 2022. Calling in grounded energies for Capricorn, May 2022. Okay, Capricorns, ground your energy as we pull your base tarot. Within your elevation of spirit, we have the Page of Pentacles. Within your healing, we have the King of Pentacles. Within your work and business endeavors, we have release. For May, within your personal life, we have the Three of Cups. And within your unexpected surprises, Capricorn butterflies, we have the Two of Swords. Calling and clarifying energies for Capricorn, May 2022. Earth sign energy, devil card representation energy. Calling in Capricorn energy, aptitude for business and energies, optimism goals. Calling in Capricorn energy, May 2022, clarifying energy from the ancestors for Capricorn, May 2022. Calling in clarifying energies, for Capricorn, May 2022. Clarifying energies for Capricorn, May 2022. Okay, Capricorn butterflies, let's break down these cards. So for your elevation of spirit in May, I'm seeing the Page of Pentacles. So a lot of you are really thoughtful in your work. The guides are calling you to get to work. This is an excellent opportunity that's being presented to you in May. So there's a lot of good news about your career, promotions. Not surprised to see the Page of Pentacles within a Capricorn reading. And also you have alchemy energy that's with you with the Magician. So you're really being elevated here into your career, into the ideas that you have, and that's going to really elevate your spirit and understanding this new path that you're on that we saw within the Oracle cards. We also have the King of Pentacles. So we are entering into the Taurus new moon, the solar eclipse, April 30th. So to see this Page of Pentacles and also King of Pentacles energy, that is such a powerful combination here, meaning that a lot of your finances are really manifesting during this time, Capricorns. A lot of compassionate energy around you. It's a really good time for success, good energy. And when you have the Page of Pentacles within your elevation of spirit and also the King of Pentacles, this is showing me that not just financially, but also health-wise, you're thinking about how you can take care of your health, your body. You're thinking about how you can take care of your home. There's just a really good supportive energy. Also, for some of you, you could be healing with a King of Pentacles energy. So you either could have maybe a supportive parent or a spouse, but this is a really good partnership for those of you that have been awaiting this King of Pentacles, someone who is just very financially stable. And I do see that with that Page of Pentacles, there will be an offer that's coming your way that will really start to elevate things. So there are just multiple connections here for how you're elevating your spirit, both on the material and personal. Now we do have the Judgment card that's supporting the King of Pentacles. So there is an air of, you know, making sure that you are strong in your beliefs with the Judgment card here. Sometimes the King of Pentacles can be really strong in how you want to do things, how you want to move through things. And so in thinking about your own energy as this King of Pentacles, just think about how you're balancing things, how you're actually bringing things into fruition with this Magician, how your ideas are organized. It's just really good energy around there, Capricorn, for May. Now, within your work and business endeavors, the Archangel card here that's coming out is release. So many of you are releasing those things that were holding you back previously. There's a big spiritual transformation. So I'm just getting messages of alignment. Many of you are aligning with where you're meant to be within your career. And this Knight of Cups here is showing me that there could be an offer that's coming your way for you to do something you really enjoy, something that you've been looking forward to. Perhaps some of you thinking about this creative blocks, you could be artists, you could be getting a call to do some performance or getting a call to maybe write something or write an article or something in business within leadership where you can use that creative mind. The guides are really showing that there's a release here and there's an offer that's coming in with the Knight of Cups that you'll really feel more connected and grounded with and bring you a lot of passion within your work life here in May. For unexpected surprises, we have the Two of Swords, and within your personal life, we have the Three of Cups. So there's a lot of good celebration here, some good announcements, you know, maybe it's a time of connecting with family. Now what's interesting here though, as much as there's the Three of Cups, the guides are also asking you to take some rest here in May. So maybe don't party too much in May. If you have a lot of invitations that are coming your way, make sure you take some time to rest. For some reason, I'm getting event planner. Maybe some of you are planning some good events here, Capricorn, in May for friends. So just make sure that you're resting with these good celebrations. And also thinking about what you say. With the Four of Swords, there's always this note of like watching what you say, maybe even practicing just listening with your family and folks around you, whether you're single or in shared soul space partnerships, just making sure that you're resting what you say and enjoying this emotional fulfillment. And if you are planning a lot of things, physically taking time to rest. Now, I do see that within your unexpected surprises, there is a choice that you'll need to make, and you're not sure where you want to go within this decision. There's a bit of confusion around it, and the guides honestly are not as clear as I'd like them to be about it. So let's pull one more card for you, Capricorn. So this is showing the Knight of Wands. For some of you, this is a past love. For some of you, this is a past intention of someone you're coupled to, or a past kind of love intention from a family member. But you're trying to make some choices. This could be connected to why you need to rest. I'm just getting this message that there may be some of you Capricorns that go into some situations in May where you're planning an event or you're out in community, and you might be confronted with this kind of Knight of Wands energy, this character that's maybe a little bit younger, a little bit more suave, it'll put you in a state of possible confusion, or you might just not know what to do. So the guides are giving you just kind of this heads up, is what I'm sensing here with the Two of Swords, that you might feel stuck, but you're not stuck. You have some choices. Don't overanalyze the situation when it does appear. Remember that you have choices, Capricorn butterflies. So with that, for May 22, Capricorns, remember, even when things aren't perfect or don't seem to be working out, just choose to trust in life. Any creative blocks that you are feeling in the month of May, just release those to the spiritual guides, call on God, call on the ancestors, and also remember that although you're not aware of it, whatever is not working out, there are full positive outcomes that are on the way, and that those gray clouds will soon be lifted by radiant soft light. So with that, Capricorn butterflies, that is your full May 2022 reading. Okay, for those of you that have stayed around for the entire Earth Signs May 2022 reading, thank you so much for supporting all of the Earth Signs. This was such a beautiful reading to be able to connect with you all. Just sending you off here with some burning Palo Santo, sending you all off on your journeys. Thank you so much for your likes, your subscribes, your donations. For those of you that also follow along via the blog and podcast, thank you so much for connecting with me and allowing me into your home. All right, Earth Sign butterflies, until next time, thank you all so much, sending you so many blessings. Goodbye.